There was really no care in the past client anymore. It was all mailings and everything else, and it just kind of petered out. And I also became a broker owner, and I still sell, and I have the same problems that they did about having a really good reason and an exciting reason to reach out and talk to people. And so we incorporated a series of events. We've had a couple really big hits, and some are kind of meshed in with some community events, but the thing was that when we would run a client event, we did it in such a way that I have a small office of 12 agents where two agents really dug out with them, so they would do that together. We've done shredding events where the clients could, we'd call and say, you can come an hour early. But our biggest event to date that we're really going to drill on over the next future anyway is movie events. We did this, we were able to land a theater for the Star Wars premiere the very next day after it came out at midnight. We had a beautiful theater that's really high end nowadays. Those theaters are not what they used to be. I've done movie events 10, 12 years ago, the little tiny theater in the community. It was really cute. But it's a whole new level now when you go to the movie theater. It's also a whole new cost. And so we negotiated and we were able to expand depending on our guest list, where each agent and myself included would know about how many people we were going to get. But we did it ahead of time enough that they would be able to call 2 months ahead and say, hey, listen, I know it's really far ahead. It is in December, so you know that's always a funky month of scheduling for personal family and everything else. But they had 3 distinct times that they were going to call people and confirm how many people they needed. They want to bring a couple friends, anybody that's referred them. And so we had a big blizzard that day, and we still had over 250 people show up. And it made me realize, and I try to lead by example, it made me realize I picked up the phone of people I could not stand. Clients that gave me trouble, but I picked up the phone and said, you know, we're taking the high road. We have their business. We should be thanking them no matter what. It's the best thing and the most eye-opening thing I've ever done, because that client said, I can't believe you called me, and that's so nice that you did that. I called right before the event, and it turned out they couldn't go, but they went out to dinner with somebody that night and was saying, you know, we were really rough on this guy, and he still took the high road and invited us to this great event. And those people were selling the house, and I have their $750,000 escrow. So the proof is in the pudding, and the event didn't really cost me a whole lot. I underwrote whatever seats weren't filled for the office, but we'll get better at it as we go. But now I'm learning to plan so far ahead. We're going to do it twice a year. We're going to make sure there's kind of more of a family kid thing movie mid-year. And then Star Wars can be iffy. Some families were concerned because, you know, it's all on how violent it's going to be. So that's one of our biggest events. We do some apple picking, the shredding day, which is very common and it's pretty much free. But the one thing I will say, no matter what events that we do as agents or programs, whatever, I've always drilled down and take $100 from every single transaction and put it in a different checking account, because it is so, so tough to dig into your pocket when the market is slow, and that's when you should be spending the money. And so that discipline alone will change an agent's business, I swear to you, because they look at that money adding up and they, oh my God, I haven't spent it. And so very eye-opening. And the big thing was, they have a real exciting reason to call somebody, and the call reluctance is gone. It's out of their head. They don't even think about it.
That's a huge takeaway. Don't write that down and take $100 out of every deal. Hey, Gary, I know that Massachusetts is probably higher than some parts of the country, but ish, what does it cost to rent out the movie theater for a whole showing?
We got a pretty good deal. Originally, it was going to be about the equivalent of $12, $14 a head. And it's always when they're not open, and that's the key. Always Saturday mornings, most major theater chains are not open until 12 or 1 o'clock the matinee. They want to fill it. They want to spread out their fixed costs. So, we ended up with 200 and some odd people. I think it cost, gross was $4,000 for 3 screens that they were half empty because not everybody showed up. But the beautiful part was we had the flexibility at the last minute to grab another screen if all of a sudden, because we were really worried, like, oh my God, if we only get 1 screen for 150 people and 200 show up, that's even worse than not inviting them at the same time, because they're just going to be turned away. I heard that happened to somebody and there was no push. So we built in that flexibility. But the agents paid $12 a head, that's all I asked them to pay. My office underwrote it and it cost me $700, and it was a huge hit. It went viral, just like some of the other speakers have talked about the importance. We had a 6'5" Darth Vader costume, professional costume, a stormtrooper. Thank God he's someone with 6'5". He was pretty sweaty, but it worked out well. The cutest thing ever, though, the most viral picture was, they have real strict rules about costuming now with security and everything. And so people can't go in costumes, and some Star Wars people really dig that. But there was this cute little kid, and he was dressed up as Darth Vader, and he walked in, and he looked, and he took a step back. He was intimidated. And then just like that TV commercial, you know, Darth Vader's waving to him, he walked up, and walks up and pulls out his sword and he goes like this. And the best picture ever was Darth Vader put the sword out and the swords are touching and he turned to the camera and it looked just like it was worth everything. And that picture went so viral in that sphere. To date, this was just last December, to date I have 11 referral new clients that are in various stages from that one family of that little boy. So you win their hearts, that's what we're here for.
Thank you very much, that's fantastic.
Any manager of the movie theater, they're welcome to take the calls. I mean, they really do. They're not losing really any ticket sales. In fact, they make more money off of us because we're filling every seat, even if we're not. We're paying for every seat we've filled. So that's what they bank on. They don't charge you more. They certainly don't charge you less. But they act as if they're going to fill that theater. If it's 150. That's what you pay for when you fill it.
And if you pick up the phone and call the manager instead of just making an email for the website, you might make a contact with the manager too. So pick up your phone.
That's why we went down and talked to the person.
Exactly. All right, Brian, you are doing something entirely different. Tell them what's going on in your business.
Totally. I've only been a licensed agent for 10 years, so if you do the math, that means 2007 I got into the market. That's when the market went into the toilet. So it is my fault and my fault. So what I want to do is build my business FOC free of charge. One of the things I found was Zillow reviews. I currently have over 220 Zillow reviews. It's the most in the entire state of Pennsylvania. So I market that I have the most Zillow reviews of any agent in the entire state. I put that on all my marketing. And I have people contacting me, come list me. I haven't been on a listing appointment against another competitor, and I can't even tell you how long, because they see the reviews, they read everything the clients say. I make sure I reply to every single review, and whenever I do, I praise them and thank them for using me, and I make sure I put up a little challenge or barrier that we all overcame, whether it's multiple offers and I got them the list price, so all the other people in the following years that read that are going to know that I have the tools that other people don't have. Now, the way I get some of those reviews is I have a custom drip campaign that Lee was talking about in her class. I actually went in and didn't use the standard drip, customized it, so day 30, day 60, and day 90 after the closing, whenever they're pretty much settling around, is whenever it hits them. And the first one is basically just me asking them for the review and telling them how important it is to my business. The second one is going to be me doing something called screencast, where I actually record me going, record my screen, going to Zillow, and then finding me on Zillow, clicking or write a review, and writing a review, so in case they're not very tech savvy.
Hold on, that's freaking brilliant. Are you serious? So you're using what, Screencast-O-Matic for that?
It's called Screencast, yeah.
So I look for a program called Screencast. I use Screencast-O-Matic. I never thought of doing that.
I use Screencast for my CMAs. I use Screencast for my price reduction.
Do you send this video to them to show them how to give a review?
Yeah, it's in the drip campaign.
There you go, Linda. There's your answer, girl.
And then one of the other drips, the third drip is an actual PDF document that has like arrows on where to go and steps on how to get to the Zillow review. Yeah. And then at the end of the year, if I don't get the review, I send out mom videos personally to each person begging them for the review. And honestly, I got 8 to 10.
What's the script on begging?
I know, but honestly, I just get up out of bed, put the laptop on my computer, because I'm actually pretty pissed at this point in time they haven't given it to me. And I record it with the news on, and I'm in my pajamas asking for a review. And I just got 8 to 10 new ones from 2016 clients that did not give me the review.
What did you say? And you're pissed off?
I just said, we closed this transaction. Each one's different. It depends.
Talk to me. I didn't give you a review. Yeah. You got a medium transaction.
Okay. So you remember our transaction 123 Anywhere Street? Zillow reviews are super duper important to my business, and I want to help other people. You found me on Zillow. I want to help other people. people find out Zillow. The same way, your review is really important. I also donate $75 to the Local Children's Miracle Network in your name, my personal funds, for every Zillow review that is posted. And then to bring up something in the transaction that may have happened. Remember to bring your hand, I'm going to go back and look at the different color tile on the backsplash. Super inconvenient. Remember I did that for you? Here's the one. I always incorporate the link. So I copy and paste the link for the Zillow review in the Mama email. And I think I hate to tell them about that. So. And then, it's cyclical now. Everybody finds me on Zillow. I have people asking me, buyers asking me, if I can take them on as a client. And like I said, I have sellers just, I don't even know if this is a bunch of things.
Y'all better have written down a few things on that one.
I have business cards.
That is Brian, TEYSSIER. He's in Pennsylvania. By the way, at the end, all of these fine people brought some business cards. We're going to set them up section by section so y'all can get a card and have the appropriate agent. That's freaking awesome. All right, Jen, talk about it, girl. Come on.
It's hard to follow that. I'm Jen Burkamper from Central Iowa. I've been doing this for 17 years. And like Gary, I started from the beginning as being very customer service driven. Big client care is very important to me. So probably the biggest thing that I have fun with is I like to do Popeyes. Does anybody out here like to do Popeyes? I've increased my business just over last year 84% because I really put a plan together to take care of my past clients. I bought one of these for each of you guys. I've got one for you guys too. But anyway, it's the easiest thing you can do. It's cheap. They usually cost me between $2 and $10. I do about 30 a month. You have to, like anything, you have to plan ahead. So in November when I'm doing my business planning, I figure out what I want to do for the entire year. So I know what I'm going to do in January, February, March, all through the year. And I've been doing this very consistently and intentionally for about 4 years. And I'm really seeing a lot of great results as we go forward. Just in January here, I also took a bunch of baskets to like my local schools for my teachers. Love to work with teachers and police officers, fire department. So I dropped off 15 different baskets to local businesses, really wanting to tell them how much I appreciate what they do for our communities. So the things that, you know, depending on the category that I have them in my, I schedule it all in my contact management software. And
which one do you use?
I just switched from top producer. I've been top producer for probably 15 years, and I just switched to referral maker because it's very easy. It tells me exactly which Popeyes I need to do and when. So I've really enjoyed that. A lot of the agents in my office are, you know, starting to incorporate this too. And a couple of them have now come up to me lately and said, I get it now. I get why you do this. It makes you feel good. Everybody likes to get a gift, and everybody likes to receive it or give gifts. So it's something that's very easy for me to do. I don't always get them all delivered myself. I mean, my assistant does end up delivering some of them. And people just love to come home and see a little gift sitting on their doorstep. So that's what I do. If anybody has any questions, it's really a lot of fun, and people appreciate. I just got a referral from a past client that I may not have had, but I had just delivered something in January, so I was top of mind. So it made them think about it. Sometimes they think, or you know, they might feel obligated a little bit to think of somebody. When lenders bring me stuff, I try to think, who can I send to that person? So that's what I do. If anybody has any questions, I'd be happy to answer them.
I do. Is it the same 30 people every month, or how do you pick who the 30 people are?
Depending on how I have it categorized, my New Brown Diamonds, they're going to get something usually about every 30 days. And then as it goes down, you know, it'd be 60 days, 90 days, 120 days. But along with, I do client parties, I do birthday cards, a lot of the stuff Kimberly talked about earlier in her session, I'm constantly in communication with them. So, I mean, it's almost to the point where some of them might take out a restraining order. I don't know.
Until they do, you're...
80% of my business is repeat or referral from from my past clients.
So the other question is, how do you decide what to give out? Where do you get your ideas? Oh. These cost effective, because they're under $10, so obviously you have a good source of ideas.
Kimberly mentioned a lady from San Francisco that has PopEyeIdeas.com. I stumbled across that a few years ago. She's brilliant, like Kimberly said. She has great ideas. She's always updating it with ideas. So, and she has little taglines, cheesy little taglines you can put on it, or you can Pinterest. You can find, just walking through the store, you can find different ideas.
Fantastic. And I forgot to mention, Brian and Jen both have some checklists and some information for y'all that we can have uploaded to your app, that you can download some of these pieces of information. Would that be helpful to y'all?
Yes.
All right, Pete, I'll get that to you so you can upload it because I haven't given it to you yet. All right, Juan, talk to us about what's working in your business.
Okay, hi everybody. I'm Juan, I come from Valencia, Spain. And well, the first thing I want to say is that it's really exciting to be here today. I'm very nervous, but I think everything is gonna be all right. Because of language too, so I'm gonna do my best. So, it's a great honor to be here, and thank you. It's great. So, the thing we are doing in RealMark is what we call micro events. I entered this profession when I was 19, I'm 28 right now, yeah. And I'm she was like, wow. I'm a CRS since I was 23. Yeah, I had to wait 5 years in the profession, if not it would be at 21. And I've lived the crisis in Spain. It began at, I think that Lehman Brothers breakout was at 2008. So in Spain, the crisis began 1 year later. So there have been very tough years where the relationship with my clients were the most important thing. There were no years to be rich or to gain a lot of money. I have never asked for a loan or something. But I survived thanks to keeping good relations with people. So in RealMark micro events, we have begun now in 2016. We are 25 people, and we have encouraged our agents to maintain a different approach in these relations. You know what? We hate to do knock or something. No, don't knock it. We hate that. You too. Okay. So, yes, in addition, in Spain, the profession is not as regulated like here. You don't need a license. So people have a very bad image of the profession because anyone can be a real estate agent. Okay, so you can imagine. So when you ask and you say, hello, I'm a realtor, you're like, I don't want to. Okay? Yeah. So what we are doing right now is we tell the agents, okay, what you can do is to invite an expert, I don't know, about makeup or mindfulness or yoga coach. You invite him to cover to the market center. And you invite all your friends, your family, and 3-4 of your best clients. Okay? So, we bring a lot of wine, very important, a lot of Spanish cheese, and a lot of snacks. So people begin to relax. And the agent too, because agents are very nervous. It's like me now. We don't have this philosophy in Spain or in Europe. It's more difficult to talk in public, so we are very afraid, even to 50 people. It's not like in America. So agents are afraid. So what we do in order to relax them is center, and the agent only speaks for 2 minutes. until he says, okay, you are wondering why you are in a real estate agency for listening about yoga. It has nothing to do at all. So people are like, because they think they are going to be sold something and it, like it's a trap. You see?
Yes.
I want to catch you. We love people, we love to make relations, and we love to do it in a different manner, in a more fresh manner, more fresh manner. We love fun, we are Spanish, so we love party and having fun. And if you have any, if you know any seller or buyer that wants to sell or buy a house, please, I'm here to help you. And then, it's the expert time, and he does the course. It's like 40 minutes, 1 hour. And but people are very relaxed, very comfortable. And after that, we have the networking. So we have the wine, the snacks, and everything. And we do what Cristina is morning there. He's a friend from Spain, also from another region. He says gin working, or wine working. You know, with gin tonic or with wine. He says that. And that's it. So the first time. Agents only invite their friends, etc. Their sphere of influence, the narrow one. But when people feel so good, they begin to bring new people. It's a very good way to know new people. And in addition, we are always saying that it's very important to call our sphere of influence, our friends and clients, almost every 2 weeks, every month. And here it's wonderful because you are face to face with these people. 25, 30 people at a time, and that's very powerful. You save a lot of time, and that's it. Yeah.
So Juan, let me ask you a question. You're obviously far younger than most of our audience. When you have these events with yoga and wine and real estate on the edge, is that primarily millennials who show up? What age group is coming to these events?
Actually, our real estate agents, our agents are like 42 years old, media average. Yeah, 42, 45.
So the people,
So the people they bring are like same age, like from 40 to 60, more or less. 40, 60.
So do the millennials show up for this? Do your friends come to you?
No, but I want to begin to do something.
Which might be
wild. Yeah, because in Spain, work conditions, the market is very tough. So even my friends have trouble abroad. Even America or France, Germany, etc. So they were all very far from me, but they are becoming to return. They miss home. So, and they are very well prepared and everything. So I was thinking these days about inviting them to the office. Yeah.
That is super awesome.
Sleep.
In my opinion, more than a competition. I want to lead by example.